Welcome to part two of our Tuesday tip today. Again, I have with me Deanna Baker, the lead voucher specialist for Navigate Affordable Housing. Last week, we talked about the five nines not having signatures, and we promised to tell you about the extenuating circumstances. So I do want to remind you that HUD says the owner may consider extenuating circumstances when an adult member is not able to sign the 5-9. So, Deanna, tell us some extenuating circumstances and how your department handles them.
Okay, so we're going to go back to the MAT User's Guide, Chapter 7, 7.5, Paragraph 4, B and C is where we're looking. And extenuating circumstances will allow a manager to submit a certification without a signature in certain situations. If you read bullet point B of chapter 7, it tells you that some examples of that would be an adult serving in the military who's deployed, a student who's away at college, an adult who has been hospitalized for some kind of medical issue or placed into a rehab facility for something. Those are types of situations where an extenuating circumstance code would be acceptable.
Okay. And what happened with me on property is the manager says, going back to our first airing, the manager says, I asked, why don't you have this 5-9 sign? And the manager said, because she's been in the hospital. Okay, that's understandable. You missed one. Then the second one I ran across, why haven't you gotten this 5-9 sign? Oh, he's in a nursing home and whatever have you. Now, HUD does say that there are extenuating circumstances and there are codes that you could use to process your voucher with. But it also says in the handbook that you have to put a note to the file as to why you did not get the 5-9 sign and when you plan on getting it signed, and there was nothing in the files to that effect.
Yeah. In Chapter 7, it tells you the exact same thing that the 4350 Chapter 5 is telling you. You have to specify, document in your file why you didn't get the signature, whether it was a rehab or a hospitalization, and when you intend or expect to get that signature so that you have something to look for. If Vicki had seen that in the file and they had said they were looking for a signature on August the 31st, then Vicki would have been expecting a signature on 9-2.
Yes.
So that gives something for the reviewer for us to look at. If HUD were to show up on your property to do an audit, that would be the same expectation that they would have. And you want to make sure that you are doing what the regulations say. Vicki referenced the codes. You will find the acceptable codes in your software. If you want to look at them outside of the software, you would find them in the MAT User Guide, Chapter 5.
Okay. Is there anything else you want to enlighten our viewers on in terms of extenuating circumstances? It's hard for managers to get away with that without documenting the file as they should and without using the code that needs to be there.
We would catch the code. If you use an incorrect code, one of the examples we've seen is where the indicator is marked saying there is no signature, but they've signed it. So it was an accidental mark. We would catch the coding. You would catch the actual signature not being there if you caught it and called back to us.
Okay. So remember, you can have extenuating circumstances to be the reason that you did not get a 5-9 signed. However, make sure you document your file and make sure you use the right code. Now, this kind of ends our session on extenuating circumstances, but Deanna, something came up between our last viewing and this viewing, and that was about special claims and some other things. So, I want you to tune in next week so you can catch that part of the 50059. We'll see you then.
Did you like this video? Hit the like button below. Do you want to see more content just like this? Be sure to subscribe to all our social media platforms. And if you know someone who could really use this information, be sure to share it.